Whenever we change products, we go through a period that's called transition. And transition is a where one product is waning and the other one is coming up. Performance slides. So the more transitions we put birds into, the less control we actually have over coccidiosis. So what we want to do is maintain a steady program and a planned time to change things. Planning my rotation is often based on the ancillary benefits as opposed to the action of the ionophore. So doing this, Moniband is one that keeps birds eating. So we don't have any, in the hot weather, we don't have any reduction in feed intake. Even over non-medicated controls, it improves. So again, planning it in the right place, it's more for the ancillary benefits than it is for the actual mode of action of the ionophores. We'll raise the level at certain times of the year and reduce it at the other times of the year, staying on the same product. We have customers who have gone 5 to 7 years on a single product and not had significant issues other than raising or lowering that product. So one way of doing that is through the technical team working with the customer to better understand their process, their cycle times, and what we can do to improve that. The way resistance develops, because the ionophore works to poke a hole, physically make a hole in the organism has to harden its outer shell in order to avoid that, and in doing so, it becomes less efficient at propagation. Given enough time, that propagation can still occur, even though it's not as efficient, we would raise the level of ionophore and overcome that. So the perception that we're just going to get total resistance and not be able to use it is incorrect because it's a physical process that's going on. They insert themselves into the cell wall and create a channel through which sodium is passed. And when sodium passes through, water follows it. Eventually the cell itself, which has a finite energy source, uses all of its energy to kick that water back out until it runs out of energy and it dies. It does the same thing to the host cells, but the host cells have infinite amount of energy, so we don't see the same process happening to them. Elanco has a long history between the sales team, which are very well technically trained, and the technical consultants. And we'll sit down and we'll say, okay, let's look at what your challenges are, what type of product are they producing? Does that incur times of the year when they may have to tighten their schedules a little bit? Then we can sit down and find the best product at the best time, and those concerns then are lowered because we know we're targeting what they need, not just randomly picking off the shelf what might go in there.